Okay, so in previous lecture, we discussed about the stream sanitation and self-purification of stream. So we are going to design a treatment plant for removal of maximum solute from that wastewater or industrial effluent, okay, which may contain BOD, COD, solid, chloride, okay. But the ultimate disposal of wastewater of effluent, it is nothing but the dilution or either disposal on the land. Okay. So we already discussed the dilution. It is nothing but the disposal of effluent or wastewater into the larger water bodies. Okay, like a river, stream, ocean, or lake. Okay, and second, disposal on land. Directly we can dispose over the land. Okay, so these are the ultimate disposal of wastewater or effluent. Okay. Then we discuss about the self-purification of stream. Okay, so when the wastewater is discharged into the river or stream, the BOD of mix increases initially and DO level starts falling. As river water travels further, BOD gradually reduced and DO increases and reaches its saturation level. Thus, the river gets purified on its own. This phenomenon is known as self-purification of stream. Okay, so self-purification, it is nothing but when we discharge any wastewater or any effluent into the water, then which contains organic matter which going to be added into that water. Okay, so depending on the hydrography of the stream, that suspended matter is either settled down at the bed of that point of the discharge or either it is carried along the water to the downstream site. Okay, so at the same time, the aerobic microorganism which utilize the organic pollutant as a source of their food and energy and grow till the food supply is adequate for them. Okay, so thus what happens? The organic matter is stabilized under aerobic condition. So thus the removal of organics is done by the first thing is settling and adsorption. And second thing is microbiological activities, that is oxidation of organic matter. Okay, so it is the process happen in the self-purification process where the after some time the food supply get exhausted and the life activities of microbial population comes to an end, and that decreases the BOD content of that water. Okay, so this process is called a self-purification process, and the water becomes now clear and the stream return its original condition. Okay, so in short, self-purification, it is when the wastewater effluent is discharged into natural stream, the organic matter is broken down by bacteria to ammonia, nitrate, sulfate, carbon dioxide, etc. In this process of oxidation, the dissolved oxygen content of natural water is utilized, and due to this, what happens? Deficiency of dissolved oxygen is occur, and thus the excessive organic matter is stabilized and the water becomes clear and a stream returns to its original condition. So this process is known as self-purification of stream. Okay, so as we know, this self-purification process is a very slow process. It takes a longer time, sometimes many of days for the completely purification of water. Okay, so various factors that affecting this self-purification process. Okay, so these natural factors affecting self-purification process are some of the physical forces and some of the biochemical forces that affect the self-purification. Okay, so this is what the structure of after the disposal of effluent into water bodies. You can see that pipe which is going to be disposed the effluent or wastewater into water bodies, and you can see the different fish system and aquatic system which present in water. Okay, so these are the different types of zone which occurs in water system, that is clear zone, then decomposition zone, then septic zone, then recovery zone, and clear water zone. So these are the five zones where, okay, which occurs in self-purification process of polluted stream. Okay, so how or what is the working of clear zone, what is the working of deoxygenation zone, septic zone, recovery zone, what happened exactly, that going to be discussed Okay, next, next disposal by dilution. We already discussed the disposal by the two method, by the dilution method and disposal on land. So disposal by dilution is the process in which the treated wastewater from ETPs, effluent treatment plant, is discharged into a larger static bodies of water or in a moving water bodies such as river and stream. Okay. So that means we can discharge that effluent into stream, river, lake or ocean. The discharge wastewater is purified in due course of time by the self purification of natural water. The effluent discharge and degree of treatment of wastewater depends upon the self purification capacity of stream and its intended water use. The conditions favorable for the dilution without treatment and with treatment that we already discussed in previous lecture. So, without treatment, if you want to dispose, in case the wastewater is quite fresh, that means you have to discharge within 2 to 3 hours of its collection. Next, suspended solid has been removed from that wastewater. Next, the volume of receiving water bodies is more than the wastewater discharge. Okay, that means where the receiving water bodies has large volume in comparison to the volume of contributed wastewater. Next, the dilution water having high DO content to satisfy the BOD of wastewater. Next, wastewater does not contain the toxic substances, mostly the industrial waste which causes the toxic substances. So wastewater does not contain toxic substances when we are going to dispose without treatment. Next, water is not used for drinking immediately after the point of discharge. So these are the various conditions favorable for the dilution of effluent and wastewater without treatment. Now, what are the conditions essential for the treatment before disposal by dilution? So, same conditions. First thing is where the wastewater which contains industrial waste, toxic substances, it needs complete treatment. When the industrial wastewater is in warm condition, which may be create fires, so it required treatment. Next, where the receiving water body has less volume in comparison to the volume of untreated wastewater. That is, the volume of diluting wastewater is insufficient or less. In that case, we need treatment of water. Next, when the receiving water is used for drinking purpose, for navigation purpose, for agriculture purpose. Okay, so in that case also we need the treatment of effluent and industrial waste. Okay, so it means without treatment or without complete treatment, we can't dispose our effluent into the water bodies. Okay. Next, standards of dilution. In that dilution factor we discuss. So dilution factor, it is nothing but the quantity or the volume of diluting water or receiving water to the, it is a ratio. So dilution factor, it is a ratio of the quantity or the volume of diluting water or receiving water to the volume of or the quantity of wastewater or effluent discharge. So when the dilution factor is above 500, in that case no treatment is required. Raw sewage can be directly discharged into river. When the dilution factor between 300 to 500, we require primary treatment such as primary sedimentation tank or primary sedimentation, and the suspended solid should not be more than 150 mg per liter. Okay. Next, when the dilution factor between 150 to 300, we required some other treatment like a sedimentation for suspended solid. Next, screening for removal of floating solid. Then chemical precipitation for a dissolved solid. Okay, and the suspended solid should not be more than 50 to 60 mg per liter. Okay, next, when the dilution factor less than 150, in that case, we require sewage should be, or a wastewater effluent, industrial effluent should be treated thoroughly. Okay, that means the suspended solid should not more than 30 to 50 mg per liter, and 5 days BOD for the same should not be more than 20 mg per liter. Okay. It means when the dilution factor less than 150, we require complete treatment of that effluent and wastewater, that is screening, then sedimentation, then coagulation, chemical precipitation, then activated sludge process, trickling filter and disinfection. Okay, so this all primary, secondary, tertiary treatment we required during the disposal of effluent and wastewater. Okay, so this is what the dilution factor and the stream standard. Okay, so as the increasing pollution of surface stream by the discharging of wastewater and industrial wastewater, okay, domestic wastewater and industrial wastewater, that's why this dilution factor, this stream standards are laid down. Okay, so these standards are known as receiving water stream standard. Okay. So similarly, the industrial effluent standards are also, that is called as effluent standard. Okay. So these are effluent standard for the disposal of industrial waste into the public sewers and water bodies. Okay. So that chart going to be discussed in later. Okay. So next, we discuss about the self-prevection of natural stream and how the self-prevection occurs in stream. Okay. So what are the different factors that involve in self-prevection of stream? Okay. So some of the physical forces and some of the chemical forces. So physical forces, that is the dilution and dispersion. Okay. Next, sedimentation. Next, sunlight. These are some physical forces. Then biochemical forces. Biochemical forces like oxidation and reduction. So physical forces like dilution, then dispersion, then sedimentation, and sunlight. These are some physical forces which affect the process of self-purification. And second one, the biochemical forces which affect the self-purification process like oxidation and reduction. Okay, so dilution, that we already discussed. So dilution is nothing but when the wastewater is discharged into the receiving water. Dilution takes place due to which the concentration of organic matter is reduced and the potential nuisance of sewage is also reduced. Next, when the dilution is quite high, the large quantities of DO are always available, which will reduce the chance of putrefaction and pollution effect. So aerobic condition will always exist because of the dilution. Okay, so second one is dispersion due to currents. Self-purification largely depends upon the currents which readily disperse wastewater in the stream and preventing locally high concentration of pollutants. Okay, that means as a high velocity of currents, what happened? It improves the re-aeration and which reduces the concentration of pollutant. Okay. So high velocity improves aeration which reduces the concentration of pollutant. Okay, and high velocity improves re-aeration which reduces the time of recovery through the length of stream affected by the wastewater is increased. So in dilution and dispersion, we discuss about the one formula that is called as the concentration of mixture, which is denoted by C. C is equal to CSE into QSE plus CR into QR divided by QSE plus QR, where CSE, it is nothing but the concentration of sewage. CR, it is concentration of river. QSE, it is a rate of flow of sewage. Then QR, it is a rate of flow of river. Okay. So this formula we can apply for various characteristics of wastewater and effluent. So from that we can find out the concentration of mixture, that is concentration of mixture means mixture of sewage and river. That means when we are going to dispose wastewater into river. Okay. So mixture of both, that is river and wastewater, that mixture is called as concentration of mixture. So this formula we can apply for the DO, that is concentration of mixture, that is a DO from the wastewater and DO of the river. So when it's going to be combined, that is DO mix. Similarly, we can apply this formula for BOD mix. So BOD of river and BOD of wastewater. So combinedly it is called as BOD mix. Similarly, we can apply this formula for solid. So solid in the wastewater and solid in the river. Combinedly it is called as solid mix. Okay. So this formula we can apply for the suspended solid mix, for BOD mix, for dissolved oxygen mix, and also we can apply for temperature mix. Okay, so these are the different characteristics for we can apply this concentration of different impurities as oxygen, suspended solid, and BOD. Okay, so that formula is called as the concentration of mixture, C. Next, the sedimentation. So how the sedimentation affect the process of self-purification? The settleable solid. Okay, so settleable solid contribute largely to BOD will be removed by settling, and hence the downstream water quality will be improved. And due to settled solid, anaerobic decomposition may be takes place. Okay, so settleable solid, if present in sewage effluent, will settle down into the bed of river and it will help the cell purification process. Next chemical, that is oxidation. Okay, so oxidation, it is nothing but the organic matter present in the wastewater is oxidized by aerobic bacteria utilizing dissolved oxygen of the natural water. And this process continues till complete oxidation of organic matter takes place. Okay, so the stream which is capable of absorbing more oxygen through the re-aeration etc. can be purified heavily polluted water in short time. Okay, so oxidation, it is nothing but an aerobic bacteria oxidize the organic matter which present in effluent by utilizing dissolved oxygen from the river, and the process of oxidation will continue till organic matter has been completely oxidized. So this is very important action to help in the cell purification of river. Next, reduction. So reduction occurs in the stream due to hydrolysis of organic matter by biologically or chemically. Anaerobic bacteria will split the organic matter into liquid and gases, and this paving the way for stabilization of oxidation. So hydrolysis, it is chemically breakdown of compounds due to the reaction in water. Okay, so this reduction which also help for the cell purification of natural steam, that is purification of steam. Now the next one is a temperature. Temperature, it is a physical force. Okay, so at lower temperature the activity of a bacteria is low and hence the decomposition is slow, though DO will be more because increasing solubility of oxygen in water. But at higher temperature, purification will take lesser time, so amount of DO is less in water. Okay, so in this way temperature also affect the cell purification process. Next, sunlight. How sunlight effect? Okay, so sunlight helps certain microorganism to absorb CO2 and gives out oxygen, thus resulting in cell purification. So sunlight act as a disinfectant and stimulate the growth of algae which produce oxygen during photosynthesis. Hence, wherever there is algae growth, water contains more dissolved oxygen during daytime. Okay, so sunlight helps to increase the dissolved oxygen in water. Okay, so in this way, these are the different factors that affect the cell purification of natural steam. Okay, come to the next point, that is the zone of pollution in the stream. Okay, so the cell purification process of polluted stream can be divided into the different following zone. Okay, so what are the different zones of pollution in the stream? Okay, so you can see into the image, that is the first zone, that is called as, okay, in the left side you can see, that is particulates, that is DO cycle and physical indices and zone of pollution. The first zone is the clear water zone. Second zone of degradation, or either you can say zone of pollution. Next, zone of active decomposition. Next, zone of recovery. And lastly, the zone of clear water zone. Okay, and along with you can see the profile of dissolved oxygen or dissolved oxygen curve. Okay, so which indicate the saturation level is 100% at the clear water zone. Then zone of degradation, where the saturation level falls down 40% of DO. At the zone of active decomposition, it falls down zero, that is zero dissolved oxygen at that time. And again, the next zone, that is zone of recovery, which recovers the pollution, that recover its original condition, and again which increase the 40% of DO. And when at the last of this process, zone of pollution, the zone of clear water zone, where it completely recovers its original shape, original condition, where the 100% of the saturation level. Okay, so what exactly happen in these different types of zone? Okay, so what are the different zone? The first one is clear water zone. Next one is zone of degradation or zone of pollution. Next, zone of active decomposition. Next, zone of recovery. Next one is the zone of clear water. Okay, so clear water zone, where the 100% saturation occurs. Okay, so in the first image you can see, So here you can see the first zone, that is clear zone, which is the starting zone. Okay, left side you can see the clear zone where the normal clean water, we can see there are all plants and fishes are available, where all fish dissolve oxygen. Okay, next to that clear zone, what is that? The second zone, that is the zone of degradation or decomposition zone or pollution zone, where we are going to discharge our effluent and industrial waste. Okay, so what happened here? You can see the color of that water going to be changed. It is dark color, it is turbid color, and due to that, what happened? That dissolved oxygen going to be falls down here. Okay, 40% dissolved oxygen falls down. Fish life may be absent, plant life may be absent. Okay, which is harmful to the aquatic life. Whatever the conditions which are unfavorable to the development of aquatic life, algae die out, fish life may be present. Okay, and increase the COT content in this second zone, that is zone of degradation and zone of pollution. Next zone, when we go to the next, that is third zone, that is zone of pollution, that is called a septic zone or zone of active decomposition. Okay, so where we can see it is completely anaerobic zone. Okay, where the bacteria, anaerobic bacteria present, fish life absent, then sludge which settle down at the bottom. Okay, then bacteria are present, and different types of gases which evolve, that is methane and estrus and CO2, which evolve in this anaerobic process, decomposition process, and dissolved oxygen which falls down zero. So totally oxygen falls down at zero. Okay, so no oxygen present in this process, in this zone, where this zone is heavily polluted zone and darker and grayish color. When you go to the next, that is recovery zone. Now recovery zone, which covers its original condition. So now some algae reappears, some plants reappears, some fishes reappears. Okay, and dissolved oxygen now from zero to increase up to 40%. Okay, so that is the recovery zone. And at the end, you can see again clear water zone, which same like as the first zone, where the normal clear water, where the different types of plants and animal, you can see where fishes, also aquatic life, also present, and which is called as a recovery zone and clear water zone. And again, the saturation level comes to up to 100%. Okay, so in this way, the self purification occurs in the natural stream. Okay, so now okay, so in this figure you can see the duocycler, that is saturation level 100% U, next to this 40% U, in the third zone of activity composition 0% saturation, and again zone of recovery 40%, and clear water zone 100% saturation. Okay, so now we are going to discuss in detail what happened exactly. Already we discussed from that figure, and now from that graph we can understand what happened exactly in the zone of pollution along a river stream. Okay, so first one is a clear water zone. So clear water zone, it is a clear water where the no bottom sludge, no color, and clear water, and where the 100% saturation level, 100% dissolved oxygen. Okay, come to the next zone of degradation. So zone of degradation, it is a point where we are going to discharge effluent and wastewater. Okay, so this zone is just below the point of where the wastewater, sewage, and effluent is discharged. Okay, so this zone, it is dark and turbid in color. Okay, so which contain bottom sludge. Okay, again the DO reduces to 40% of the saturation level. 100% DO is already present, but now it is going to be falls down up to 40% of the saturation value. Next, it increases CO2 content. Then reoxygenation occurs, but slower than deoxygenation. Next, it is unfavorable for the development of aquatic life. Then algae die out, then fish life may be present, and different types of worms are and fungi which appears in this zone. Okay, so this zone, which is unfavorable for the aquatic system, and the dissolved oxygen which falls down up to 40%. Okay, so next, that is zone of active decomposition and zone of pollution. it will discuss in later.